today, it is too often in the wrong places, or too much at the wrong time. As spring follows winter, streams overflow and flood the towns and farmlands. When this happens, droughts and water shortages are far from our minds. But in flood or famine, the basic need still remains: well-distributed supplies of usable water. Today, the men of the waterworks industry are hard at work keeping our water supply in balance. Because local water shortages are part of a large regional problem in many instances, waterworks engineers are pooling their skills and resources on a regional and interstate basis. And on their efforts to provide abundant water in the years ahead depends the pattern of life for a nation. The stakes are high for all of us, but the job is being charted with vision and determination. Nature's pipelines, the watersheds, will have to be reforested wherever they have been stripped of their protective covering. Man-made pipelines will have to reach far out to tap the clear wilderness lakes, as well as the hidden treasures of groundwater. Reservoirs must be built to meet future growth, to harness the fury of floodwaters, to ensure against future water shortages, to raise the level of water tables. Purified wastewater will have to be returned underground. New techniques for controlling the weather are being tried. When conditions are right, rain is made to fall by seeding clouds or silver iodide. There are experiments underway to tap the vast expanse of the sea and remove its salt economically. But to provide enough water is only part of the job ahead, for our water must be safe and palatable as well. In all nature, there is no such thing as really pure water. Even rain collects particles and gases as it comes down. No matter what it once held, by the time it gets into our homes, it must be free from harmful impurities. It must measure up to federal, state, and local standards. Different types of contamination call for different treatment methods, which include flocculation, clarification, filtration, disinfection. What does this mean? It means a better, safer drink of water for you. Your drink of water may be processed in a complex plant like this. The water, not fit to use as it is, water with impurities, is pumped in here. On its way to the preliminary settling basin, chlorine or other chemicals may be added to the raw water to start the purification process. Here, the coarser particles settle out. The water continues on, flowing to the mixing chamber. Coagulants are mixed with the water to speed the settling of fine particles. In the flocculating basin, the chemicals coagulate, entangling sediment and forming clumps. The water containing these clumps is clarified by settling. The accumulated sediment is scraped into the drain. The water at the top of the basin flows onto the sand filter, where the removal of sediment, treatment chemicals, and bacteria is completed. As the water leaves the sand filter, it is almost as pure as when it left the clouds. To eliminate any remaining bacteria, minute quantities of chlorine or other purifying agents are added. Finally, safe, palatable water is pumped to the mains and reservoirs. From the treatment plant, there is still the big job of getting it to our streets and homes. This waterworks operation is a skilled and technical profession, requiring trained and experienced personnel. This is a big industry, water supply. By weight of material handled, 7 times as big as all other industries put together. To keep us supplied around the clock, it takes big installations with proper types of equipment. Buildings, basins, and filters. Power substations, electric switching equipment, electric motors and pumps, automatic pumping stations. But vast though today's waterworks installations may be, they are not sufficient for the years ahead. The United States Public Health Service reports
almost 6,000 communities with no waterworks need and could support such facilities. To meet these needs, as well as to provide for the normal expansion of existing waterworks, will mean an estimated 3,000 new treatment plants, 9,000 wells and well pumps, 8,000 water storage tanks, and more than 45,000 miles of water pipe.
We must meet these needs. We are to have enough safe water, wherever and whenever we want it. A glassful for any young citizen in the middle of the night. ...50,000 gallons on short notice to fight a fire. Several 100,000 gallons before the blaze is up. The waterworks answers to the problem. With your help, they can put their plans to work to provide plenty of safe water for tomorrow. You and I must understand and support the water supply project affecting our communities. In addition, we can see that not one drop of this life-giving liquid is wasted. The health and happiness of our communities will be determined by how well we meet the needs for safe, abundant water. For we, too, are part of the cycle, like the oak tree and the acres of grass. Without water, life dries back to a crust, a world of dust and sun. Without water, life of individuals or nations perishes.
All day I pay. He longs to rest where there's no quest for water.
Why, who?